Hello, my dear friends and my lovely viewers. Hope all you are doing very well. Today in this video tutorial, I am going to show you how to restore WordPress website from old backup. First of all, let's see the quick overview of our working procedure. To restore backup, I need a domain and a hosting. I will connect domain to hosting. Then I will upload files and database. Finally, connect database to file. That's it. Actually, my website hosting expired. I forgot to renew that. This is my website and this is totally disappeared from online. In this situation, I will wipe this website from my old backup. To do that, I have to do two things. First, connect domain to hosting. This is called name server change. Upload backup files. Let's do the first thing. I'm going to log in my domain panel. This is my domain WP Bravo and I will click to manage. I will change this name server. As it is custom, I will put my name server here. These two are my name server. You will get this name server from your hosting provider. After that, click to save. My first task is complete. Now I have to upload my backup file. To do that, I have to do two things for that. I have to upload files, then I have to upload my database. You can upload files first or database first, that doesn't matter. I'm going to log in my cPanel. This is my cPanel and you will find file manager there. Click to file manager. Then you have to upload files to public.html. As I can upload 10 websites in this cPanel, so I have separated folder for those. I have to upload my files to this folder. Then click to upload and select my file. This is my backup file. Click and it will finish uploading within 1 or 2 minutes. It will depend on your internet speed. You can upload files in several way. I'm uploading file directly to my cPanel. You can upload file through FTP. FTP takes longer time to upload files. This is why I prefer to upload to the cPanel directly. Then reload this, you will see this file. This is zip file. First, I will extract that. Done. Now I have to upload database. To upload database, first of all, I have to create database. You will see database section in your cPanel. Then click to MySQL database wizard. It will make your task easier. Create your database here, then next. Now you have to create database user. Create database user and user password stronger so that your site will be safe from hacker. I can put password here manually, but I will generate a strong password. And remember to keep this record in a separate notepad file. I will need those within the next 1 or 2 minutes. Create user. Now I will give permission to my user to access all these permissions. After that, make changes. That's it. My database creation is done. My file upload is done. There is remain only one thing, that is I have to upload my database. To upload my database, I have to go to phpMyAdmin. Here you will see your newly created database. Click to that exact database. Then click import, then choose file. This is my file. Then next to that, import. My database is also uploaded. If I go back to my site will not load. I have final one thing to do, that is connect my files to database. Now I have to add my database information. I have to add database information to this wp-config.php file. Let's open it and edit. Then edit. Here I will see DB name, DB user, and DB password. You don't have to edit any other fields. Just add DB name. This is my DB name. Add this here. This is my DB username. Add this DB username here. And finally, add this password field into this password field. That's it for now. Then save it. Yes, this is my site and this is working fine. This is very important task to take your website backup. For many reasons, your website can be down. Hacker can be hijack your site. You can forget to renew a domain or hosting. Your website can be down for updating WordPress or plugins. Those reasons doesn't matter if you have a backup. So try to take a latest backup of your website. In this case, if you are busy or if you think this is hard for you to take backup, you can hire me. You can hire me for monthly basis or you can hire me for any single task. I'm available to freelance work. So this is all for now. Hope to see you in the next video. Take care.